Hulk Hogan's Nepo baby grown men, as David Penzer seems afraid of Jim Duggan. The terrorist! The terrorist! And you thought things were bad in 2001. Hey, Jim, we don't have anyone for you to wrestle. What about the terrorist? Terrorist is Fidel Sierra under the hood, aka David Sierra, yes, Adam Luce, aka Cuba's Top Gun, aka Dave Sierra wearing a Venom mask, which we've seen before on here. Dave Sierra just had every costume. Yeah, this is when Jim Duggan was the United States champion defending America against terrorism on a Saturday morning on TBS in a wrestling match. Imagine if Jim Duggan wins this match, 9/11 doesn't happen. Should have just used Jim Duggan to handle all that stuff. Ah, Dave Sierra sold his bar. They ran indie shows for years there, if I'm not mistaken. Like, I think FCW, when they were developmental, they ran shows at Dave Sierra's bar, if I'm not mistaken. I would never do a four-day convention, Adam Luce. Because I only go to conventions for my son, Noli. He can barely handle a day. We did, like, one full day and then, like, a couple of hours at a convention back in April. And it was too much for him. Yeah, this is the gateway drug for wrestling fans. This is what makes you understand why wrestling's great. Jim Duggan versus the terrorist. No question about it, but the more I look at it, the more he looks like a Neanderthal man. I'm sure this is how W was going to solve the whole Bin Laden thing back in 2001. Just shove his head into a turnbuckle over and over. Hey, DDDYKI, welcome. Since Jim Duggan and the Sopranos, they would have probably just been like, I don't know, smoking weed. The Old Glory knee drop. Yeah, the terrorist is wearing some funky looking gear, as Jim Duggan's being saucy this week. Hey, Soggy Hydrox. Yeah, there was a Twitch update. It was weird. My phone was acting funny earlier. I was totally watching WCW. I was watching this, probably. Being little chubby Tommy sitting home, eating my bologna sandwiches and my sweatpants. I was a WCW kid. So I was all about this.
Duggan's taking it to him. He's used that power. And Larry, I believe that Hacksaw Jim Duggan...
I know, like we joked last week, there are none of these fans in this audio track are alive. They're all dead. This Seagulls track is like from 1940. He's definitely a guy you don't want to stand there and just, you know, fist the cup. The terrorist got me for a $25 shot of Patron. Oh, John Tatum, I'm sorry. I thought you said the terrorist did.
Jim Duggan, and of course, the Clash of Champions, in my opinion, a real dispute.
But terrorism in a front face. US Heavyweight Champion, Jim Duggan, nonetheless.
Duggan still sports the title. Forearm smash across the thoracic area of the back.
Brother, how about...
You know, if Nick Patrick is in charge of the battle over terrorism, America's screwed.
Championship role now possesses the Harlem Heat. Wow, it's going to be something, brother.
Putting up the thumb, brother. Boom. Clothesline. We've clotheslined terrorism. Got the pinfall.
He's a happy man. Son of a police chief in Northern...
Son of a police chief. Boo.
Tall, if you will. Well, it's easily said when you're walking around with a 2x4.
So, ladies and gentlemen, We have won the war on terror. Jim Duggan took care of it. All Hacksaws are bad. Oh, gosh. Favorite dressings in a sandwich. Got me out of nowhere with that one. Probably mayo. I'm a big mayo guy. But yeah, terrorism is defeated. We don't have to worry about 9/11. We don't have to worry about anybody leaving anthrax in any train stations in Boston.